Hey guys, back for another video. So for those of you who don't know me, my name is Oscar Savalainen. I do a lot of AI stuff, particularly a lot of neural network quantization stuff. But today, we will not be doing neural network quantization. We will be doing embedding models. And the reason for this is because I have been working on something in neural network quantization. In the background, it's taking a while. It's like a whole engineering thing that has to go into it. In the meantime, I thought I'd put out two videos in particular. One on is something I've been doing a lot at work recently, is testing embedding models. So I'm just going to show you how can you take an embedding model, spin it up on a GPU as quick as possible, just basically take a Runpod server, spin up a GPU, install an Infinity server instance, make API requests to it. So if you ever wanted to do this, and this does generalize to other models, like if you don't want to use embedding models, you just want to use LLM models or any kind of arbitrary machine learning model, you just need to use like whatever particular framework you're using. If you're using LLMs, you can use OLLAMA, you can use Llama CPP. There's a bunch of different inference engines that are available, but those are all pretty well documented. I thought I would do one on embedding models just because they're something I've been using a lot recently, and embedding models are just cool. I like them. So yeah, I'm just going to show you in this video how you take an embedding model, spin it up on a GPU as quickly as possible. We're going to speed run this. And then in my next video, I'm going to be talking about the GPTQ algorithm, because that is quantization related, and it's probably the kind of state-of-the-art quantization algorithm for large language models. I'm going to explain how it works. But anyway, today we're going to be talking about embedding models. Let's get into it. As I said, we're going to speed run this. So we're going to spin up a Runpod instance. This is just me logging in. We're going to deploy a pod. We are going to grab just the... Actually, no, that is not the cheapest GPU instance. This is the cheapest GPU instance. We will check that we have terminal access. We will deploy on demand. Here, we have to do something a bit special because we're going to be running an embedding model, and we're going to be using something called an Infinity server. So we need to expose the port for that. So the port that is kind of default exposed by Infinity server is 7997. You can change this, then you just have to change things in the code as well. But using the default should be fine. And then we're literally just going to wait for this GPU to spin up. As I mentioned, I'm running an embedding model by Infinity server. But if you wanted to run like a full-blown language model, you could do that as well. You could use OLLAMA, for example. But just for the sake of this example, I'm going to show an embedding model because that's what I've been doing it recently on. Okay, so that is all running now. So if I go to connect, and we're just going to use this basic SSH terminal, that's because that's all we're going to need right now. And I'm going to do two things. I'm going to go to my code, which I have here. I'm going to go to main, and this code is available on the GitHub, and I'm going to update this Runpod ID to just what was there in the description. And then I'm going to copy this entire line, and we're going to open up another terminal. And we're just going to paste that there. So this is just SSHing into the machine. It assumes this is just kind of the address where to SSH into. And then I'm feeding in my SSH key, which I've already set up. If I show you where that is, maybe have to be a little bit careful about this. I don't want to show my SSH key. I think it's in settings, API keys. Okay, yeah. So I added my API key. This is just an SSH key. I'm not going to show it for perhaps obvious reasons, but this should be fairly simple. I'm sure you can do this. But yeah, I'll just go back to the Runpod. And then, okay, so now I've successfully SSH'd in. This is going to be pretty simple. We're just going to install the Infinity server. This is going to take a while. It has a bunch of different dependencies. It's doing everything from Torch to like Huggingface Optimum, Huggingface Accelerate, a bunch of NVIDIA CUDA stuff. So there is a large amount of dependencies that are going to get installed here. So yeah, this is going to take a while. Okay, so that is installed. And then I'm going to do something a bit funny. I'm going to go to my README, where I basically have all of these different instructions along with like useful commands you might want to use. And I have like figures on how I did all of this, but I'm going to go here and I'm going to grab this line of code. Basically, what this is just doing is the command run Infinity server with v2. v2 is just the more advanced version of the Infinity server. And then what model I want to run. I want to run the BAAI BGE M3. This is kind of a state-of-the-art embedding model. I've done some testing on it. I've found it to be super good across a bunch of different languages. So I am a big fan. So yeah, I just set it running. And this is just kind of setting up. It's downloading the model from Huggingface, and this is pretty cool. As far as I have been able to test, this Infinity server, you can download any embedding model from Huggingface, and it's just gonna run. I think particularly any model from Sentence Transformer. But yeah, it's been awesome. It just kind of runs. And then we are literally just going to run Python main. So first my conda environment, and then Python, we'll make that a bit bigger. And yeah, here we go. So all this script was doing was taking these input texts and then embedding them. So it's getting the server embeddings for all of the different input texts, if I kind of zoom in there. And yeah, then we're just printing the embeddings, and or we're printing the text and the embeddings in a loop. If we look at it, that is what is happening. For hello world, we're getting this embedding vector. For salut, comment ça va, we're getting this embedding vector. And for todo bien, we're getting this embedding vector. But this is just a sample. I've just taken the first five values, but yeah, that's it. And then I have also printed this warning at the end that if we go to Runpod, even if we stop running the script, this is still running, right? This is still taking up our money. So when we're done, we can stop the pod. And then we can also terminate the instance. And this just means that, yeah, like all of our different volumes and data, anything that we've stored in this is also going to disappear. Make sure that you do that as well. And then you're done. That is it. Now, obviously, if you run this, this is not going to work because there's no actual server running anywhere. You don't have a Runpod instance running anymore. But that was it. That is how you speed run setting up an embedding model on a GPU instance. All right. That was it. Hopefully that was useful and or interesting. We took an embedding model, we put it on a GPU, we did an API request to it. And again, this does generalize to other models. Like if you wanted to put up a proper big LLM model that outputted like text, you wouldn't use an Infinity server like we did. You'd probably use something like OLLaMA or Llama CPP or some other LLM inference engine. But that was it for this video. The next video will be on GPTQ, like I mentioned before in the intro. That is the kind of state-of-the-art quantization algorithm. And yeah, I'll be talking about that more in the next video. And I hope to see you there. Bye. Have a good weekend, evening, day, wherever you are. And yeah, see you in the next time. And as always, code is in the description. Bye.